Christmas, everybody. Welcome to the online Sunday school service. My name is Irene Waluwita Nyambe, and I'm your presenter for today. Today's lesson is going to be on the hope of Christmas. Before we begin our lesson, let us put our hands together and pray. Father God, we thank you for today. Thank you for everything. Thank you that we're among the living. Lord, even as we're about to begin our lesson, we pray that you may be with us, help us understand everything, and put everything that we learn into practice. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving in our hearts. Amen. So right now, we are going to praise God. Enjoy. All praised along. Right now, we're going to have COVID sensitization, and after that, we'll have our memory verse from Chibamba. Stay tuned.
Do you know there's COVID? But not to fear, we can conquer COVID by following the golden rules. Rule number one, wear a face mask and face shield at all times when in public.
Rule number two, make sure you wash your hands carefully with soap and water.
Rule number three,
Sanitize your hands.
Now do this. There you go.
Rule number 4, maintain social distance.
And in as much as all these things are happening, remember, God is in control. And one day, He will take away this coronavirus. Remember what the Bible says? Now in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loves us. Romans 8:37. Remember, God will take away this coronavirus. We should always believe that. And don't forget to mask up, wear a face shield, wash or sanitize your hand. Eat healthy, avoid crowded places, and always social distance.
Hello, I am Chivamba, and for today's memory verse, it will be coming from the book of Isaiah 9, verse 6. And it says, "Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace."
I hope you learned one or two things from the memory verse. Right now, we're going to worship God, and after that, we're going to have Teacher Tendai and Chivamba to explain more on Christmas. Keep watching.
Shining, it is. The Christmas to you all.
Welcome to our Christmas special service. I'm Chiwamba.
And I'm Teacher Tendai.
And for today's Christmas theme, we're going to be learning about Christmas hope.
Yeah. Chiwamba, what comes to your mind when you think of Christmas?
I think of the birth of Jesus and what he did to the earth.
Yeah, the birth of Jesus brought peace, joy, and hope. And today's focus is on hope. Let's stay tuned and let's watch the play.
I don't know how I'm going to do it this year. Christmas is just so expensive. I don't want the kids to be disappointed. I wonder why we even bother anymore. All four of us. Lord, I miss him. It's so hard without him. Please help me this Christmas. The kids, pull it together.
Cell phone for Christmas? Why can't I get a cell phone?
Yeah, so you could talk all the time, like anyone wants to hear you more than they already do.
Be nice. Remember, Christmas is just around the corner. And I'm sorry, I don't think you're quite ready for a cell phone. Now, will you two please help me finish decorating this tree?
Yes, Mom.
Fine. I wish Dad was here. I would have had a phone right now.
What did you say?
Nothing.
Lord, what am I going to do? I don't think I can afford the kind of gifts your friends are getting. Give me your wisdom. My favorite decoration.
What? The statues and the barn?
It's called a manger scene. The whole celebrating of the homeless baby is kind of dull, though.
Now, let me tell you a story. We'll finish decorating the tree later. Come sit and listen. There once was a young lady named Mary who was very excited to be getting married to a nice man named Joseph. One day, an angel visited her and told her she would have the son of God, Jesus. But Mary was concerned on what Joseph would say, but God had that taken care of.
God, you have told me that I will carry your child. I don't understand this, but I'm willing to do your will. But God, I don't know how I'm going to do this. Joseph is going to break up with me.
Why, Lord, why? I thought Mary was your follower, your child. But look at your sisters, what they are doing to us. I thought she was special. I thought she was special. But, Lord, Lord, why? But look now, she's pregnant. Awe, but bagelova manje zona.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. And she will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will forgive the sins of his people.
Okay, Lord, I'll take Mary as my wife.
Okay.
Wow, so God sent an angel to Joseph to let him know that Mary was telling the truth?
Exactly. Joseph had gotten so upset that he was not going to take Mary as his wife until the angel spoke to him. When he woke up, he knew that Mary was telling the truth about her pregnancy and the angel, and he knew that Mary was to be his wife.
I thought Mary played a quick number on Joseph. What happened next?
Joseph had a home and worked as a carpenter, but they had to travel to be counted in a registry in the town of Bethlehem at a certain time. And that time happened to be the right time that Mary was about to have the baby. However, many people had to travel to Bethlehem that time. When they arrived, they had no place for them to stay. One innkeeper finally let them take shelter in the barn. That's why the manger scene is so special. That's where the Son of God was born.
And that's why we sing the song Away in a Manger. And when Jesus was born, a bright and shining star appeared to the wise men, who took time to study the stars. They followed the star until they found Jesus, and they came bearing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, during the time of King Herod, the wise men from the east came and asked,
"Where is the one born King of the Jews? We saw his star and have come to worship him."
When King Herod learned this, he was troubled, and all of Jerusalem with him. He called together all the leading clerics and scholars of law and questioned them where Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they answered.
"For this is what the prophet has written: But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel."
And that's the hope we find in Christ.
Mom, the story of Jesus is a sweet story, but why do we still celebrate it after all these years later? That happened like a long time ago. Now Christmas is all about gifts and Santa. At least that's what the TV says.
And don't forget about the great food, the chicken, and the brass stands. I can already smell it.
Josh, pay attention. Christmas is special because of the birth of Jesus. It shows us how much God loves us. Without Jesus, we could never do enough or be good enough to go to heaven when we die. Before Jesus was born, the Jewish people followed a strict set of rules by sacrificing sheep and other animals. These were just symbols of what God would do later by sending Jesus to earth. God's people knew that someday a Messiah was coming. It was predicted in the scriptures thousands of years later before his birth.
That's pretty cool. So the birth happened just like that, like the prophet described it?
Duh. If God predicted it, then of course it would come true.
Now let me finish telling you about the birth, so you know why it is important not to let the true message of Christmas get lost in all the other noises on TV and in the stories. God loved us and he wanted us to love him because he had so many blessings he wanted to share with us. But because of our sin, there is no way we can go to heaven or live a life of peace on our own. But God is holy and sin cannot be in his presence, and that's why the problem is for us. But God made a way for us by sending his son down to heaven, down from heaven to earth as a human to take the punishment for our sins. When Jesus was an adult, he died on the cross. When he did this, he fulfilled the promise God made thousands of years earlier.
Amen. And that is why Christmas is special. When Jesus came to earth as a baby, hope became a reality for us. Christmas is about God's love, hope, and peace that comes from knowing him.
Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel.
For unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
He was rejected and despised by men, a man of sorrows and familiar with suffering, like one from whom men hide their faces. He was despised and we stood. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Thank you.
Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed.
Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name will be called Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed that play, and I hope you've learned a lot from that play. Chibamba?
Yep, I learned a lot from that.
Yeah. So, what does hope mean?
Hope is like expecting someone or expecting something to happen.
Yeah. So hope, as Chibamba has said, is when you expect something. You're expecting a Christmas present. It doesn't mean that you have it or you're definite it will come, but it means you're expectant. So in biblical terms, hope is about expectation that's based on the promises of God. So we have these promises that God has given us, and we base our hope on that. I personally have a promise that I always stand on, Psalms 46, which says God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. When I'm in trouble, I always stand on this promise and I tell God, God, you are my present help. And I receive help in that moment. If you look at the past 2 years and what we've been through, we've seen COVID come in different variants and we've been affected. We've seen how families have been affected. We've lost loved ones. We've lost some people have lost their jobs, their income, and they're struggling. We've seen all these things that, Chibamba, make us feel hopeless.
Yeah.
Isn't that? Now, what are we saying today? Today we are saying that the hope that we have in God is not based on circumstance. It's not based on the things around us. It's based on the promises of God. That's what we are saying. And if we read from Jeremiah 7:17, it reads, Chibamba, are you able to read for us?
Yes, Jeremiah 17, verse 7, this says, but blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him.
Amen. So it says, blessed is a man who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is in the Lord, whose confidence is in the Lord. You are a blessed man if you are hopeful in the Lord. And the other scripture that we'd want to read is Hebrews 6, 19. That reads,
we have this hope as an anchor for the soul, firm and secure. It enters the inner sanctuary behind the curtain.
Amen. So our hope is certain. It is something for the soul to hold on to. It is strong and secure. It goes all the way into the most holy room behind the curtains. We have this hope as an anchor of our soul. Amen. And that is why this Christmas is very special. We celebrate because why? We celebrate the birth of Christ as it brought hope, joy, and peace that comes from knowing Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
So, wherever you are, whatever situation you are in, whatever circumstance you are in, we're going to ask you, where is your hope? Where have you placed your hope? Is it in things that you have? Is it in money? Is it in friends? Is it in the presents that you're going to receive? Or is it based on the promises of God? For some of you, you've even lost the hope. You have no hope. You've lost hope because at this time, maybe you're in isolation, you are alone, and you have COVID, and you feel lonely, and you feel hopeless. I've come to tell you that make Jesus your hope this Christmas. Make Jesus the light in the situation, in that dark situation that you have. Make Jesus your anchor, even in that situation. No matter what it is, I want your hope to be reignited, your hope to be renewed this Christmas, as we bring all our burdens before Him. Let us pray. I want to pray for people out there who feel defeated, beaten, downcast because of the things that have happened. I want to pray for you today. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this day that you've given us. Father, we thank you for this word that has come to us today. We pray, Lord, that this word may pierce down to our hearts and lift us from this situation of helplessness, from this situation of giving up, oh God. We pray, Jehovah, that may we receive that refreshment, that may we receive that renewal of hope today. Lord, oh God, may you be the anchor of our soul. May we trust in you today as we look forward, oh God, as we soldier on, oh God, through this Christmas, oh God. It's in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, we pray with thanksgiving in our hearts. Amen.
Amen. Hi there. On behalf of the Children's Ministry, would like to wish you
a Merry Christmas and a prosperous 2022.